A recent American study published in the Journal of Occupational and Environmental Medicine found that employees who travel frequently for work, as the study defines as 21 days or more, tend to have diminished states of mental health. What role could HR departments play in trying to keep employees psychologically safe during their travel and time abroad? We spoke with Rafael Gomez, a professor at the University of Toronto, and Paula Allen, a vice president at Morneau Chapelle, to hear more.
One of the main channels by which this travel frequency is affecting the health of workers has to do with the disrupted rhythms, mainly owing to sleep and the repair that can bring. You just don't repair the brain enough, and that can cause all kinds of associated problems, one of them being psychological health and well-being.
As exciting as business travel can be, as good as it can be for career opportunities, it is a bit of disruption. So even if you're around people a lot, you don't really have those deep relationships that really kind of feed you. You're talking to clients, you're on. It really does create that sense of isolation. It's physically draining. When you think about being in a plane for a long period of time, when you think about changing time zones, just being in somebody else's, like a hotel bed, isn't always so great for sleep, and that can be disrupting for people. Eating habits change. Guilt about being away from your family and friends.
I think it's actually a role for HR to know who's traveling in their organization, who's traveling a lot, and get proactive and make sure that people are healthy and feeling good. And if not, intervene, either by slowing down the amount of travel or perhaps giving people the tools that they need to maybe get better sleep when they're on the road.
In terms of what HR can do for that frequent business traveler, there really is a training and preparation that can happen. So making sure that those employees understand the risks of business travel in terms of their personal health and well-being, making sure that the services that they have, the EAP that they choose, is able to adapt to those circumstances and have available to business travelers the full range of support from a counseling, from a clinical point of view, but also from a practical tool point of view to help those business travelers. So that's really equipping people very well and making sure that you're choosing resources and choosing EAPs that have that digital component in a very strong way.
The research really shows firms benefit when employees are catered for and treated properly. And look, a person is not doing this level of traveling in an organization out of some fluke. They've been identified as sort of top performers who are on the front lines meeting with other clients. They're doing really valuable work. So to think in short-term ways is, I think, damaging to the company as well as to the individual.
From a purely business point of view, it makes sense to invest and protect your investments, your people, as well as your assignment, and not just wait for things to go randomly bad or good.
For Canadian HR Reporter, I'm Alexia Capralos.
Thank you.